Welcome, I'm Bob Tickleman, and I'm excited to be your guide for this AZ-500, Microsoft Azure Security Technologies. And we're focusing on the learning path for using Microsoft Defender for Cloud and Microsoft Sentinel. We're on the second module where we're going to focus specifically on securing and configuring Microsoft Defender for Cloud. Microsoft Defender for Cloud and Microsoft Sentinel are both powerful security solutions. They serve a different purpose and complement each other as well. Microsoft Defender for Cloud is a comprehensive cloud-native application protection platform, or CNAPP. It's designed to protect your cloud resources and workloads from cyber threats, and it provides visibility, protection, and response capabilities across multiple cloud platforms, including Azure, AWS, and Google, as well as hybrid and multi-cloud scenarios. Defender for Cloud includes services like Azure Defender, which offers threat protection and security posture management for various Azure resources, such as virtual machines, containers, storage, databases, and IoT devices. Where Microsoft Sentinel, on the other hand, is a cloud-native security information and event management, also known as a SIEM solution, that provides intelligent security analysis and threat intelligence across the enterprise. It integrates with various log sources to offer comprehensive threat detection, incident management, and automated response capabilities, sometimes referred to as a SOAR, Security Orchestration and Response. Sentinel uses logic apps for automated response, enhancing its security operations. So let's take a look at where Defender for Cloud fits in this solution. So as we've described throughout a variety of the recordings, we've been showing you the security posture defined by the Microsoft Cloud Security Benchmark and the aspects of cloud resources and what you might want to configure or manage through that resource, through the configuration of the Microsoft Cloud Security Benchmark. We're now using that Cloud Security Benchmark as the input to the Defender for Cloud, as we just described, to measure those resources and provide in a single pane of glass the response information of how our resources are configured and how they're being used, as well as performing against those benchmarks. So Defender for Cloud, as that single pane of glass, is a great place to get information in your Azure, Google, AWS, and even on-premises information, and see all of that information in this one location. And it gives you a report based around the Defender for Cloud scorecard that will summarize this information, and you can customize these dashboards to meet some of your requirements, but you're gonna get an overall score. It's gonna identify things that are maybe not in compliance. You can drill down, so it might show a number of items. You can click on that item and then see what are the details, you know, what are the resources that are not compliant or what's wrong with them. And you can drill down even farther to find out what is not compliant, and possibly even have remediation steps detailed for you so that you could then take those steps. So this scorecard gives you that inventory of the resources that you've defined, as well as the report back on the status of that resource. So when you assess your compliance against the framework, we've mentioned that that framework is going to be the MCSB that you're going to then configure these values. Now you're seeing on this slide an example of the dashboard, and across the top is a list of the number of, on the left-hand side of that, is a listing of some of the policies that have been defined. And so these are governments, whether they be NIST or some form of predefined definition of security. So you can load those policies in place so you can see that regulatory compliance that you're working with. It then shows you the controls in the bottom left-hand part of that slide that shows you all the controls that are being measured, and it gives you the scorecard against all those different controls. You can click on that, and then you're seeing that right-hand side of the screen that gives you the details about that event, and specifically you can have potential remediation that you need to take for your actions to, you know, respond to the condition that has caused that triggering of the event itself. When you take a look at the compliance standards that you're working with, there's a wide variety. I think at last count, there was over 33 regulatory compliances that have been pre-configured that you can now import and use in your Defender for cloud deployments. It then gets connected to the resources that you're going to be reporting on, and it measures those resources, you know, the policies and the initiatives, the RBACs that you have in place against those policies that you've configured. So you can see down that left-hand side of the slide that you've got your regulatory standards, and they can be deployed against either AWS, GCP, the Google Cloud, or inside of Azure itself. I mentioned that you can customize some of these standards, and you have that capability of going in and adding to your Defender policies specific features that you might be interested in for your specific configuration. So we have that ability to go in and customize that information to meet your own security definitions. Now, being able to connect to the hybrid cloud or the multi-cloud environments, you can now have the reach to your on-premises to provide that single pane of glass. So there's an ability to connect to, on that left-hand side, using deployment using Azure Arc for those resources, or from Defender for Cloud page, you can actually enroll resources through the Azure portal. And on that right-hand side, connecting to the multi-cloud environment, we then have the named resources you want to work through the native connectors that are available to GCP and AWS, or you can use the classic connector to connect to those environments, pull in the inventory into Defender for Cloud so that they too can be assessed because they're emitting that information in an industry standard so that we can measure against them. Defender for Cloud has a number of different features that are available for it, and we're not going to go through all of them, but one of them that you can enable is the Microsoft Defender External Attack Surface Management. And so that is a feature of Defender for Cloud. You'll see that we've got, I think, about 13 or 14 listed in the course material that you can now enable for the different Defender features of, you know, Azure Storage, Defender for App Services, and it now is going to take a look at that external attack surfaces, and this is information that you can import on a regular basis as new attack surfaces are identified, and I see what that attack surface is in your configuration of those resources and what you might want to do to reduce that attack surface, maybe turning off services that maybe are not used to lessen the surface and the attack that could happen against those unmonitored, unused resources. So just a quick introduction to Defender for Cloud and its single pane access to all of the resources for either inside of Azure, across your multi-cloud environment, or your on-premises to bring into a measurement and a dashboard where you can now assess the state of your compliance requirements across your entire infrastructure that you've deployed, see what that measurement is, and potentially have an action plan to build a response to remediate those non-compliant objects. So that's it for this recording. I look forward to seeing you at the next recording in the series.